Hi everyone and welcome back. So today we are going to talk about e-learning module in Odoo. E-learning module helps to create online courses and visitors can join the course and complete their course. They also gain some points according to some rules that is being set, and they can be given some badges or certificates based on these points. So there are a lot of things that is within this module. We can go through that. When we open this module, you can see an e-learning overview which contains a lot of courses that was created and some overview of all the courses. Here there is some courses, you can see basics of gardening and which has some tags like basic gardener, quiz, dog friendly. And when you click this view course, you can directly go to the website and join the course, or you can start the course. Then you have contents. These are all the contents within this course and who are the attendees of this course, who all finished this course, and reviews can be viewed. We will go through it later. Then views. You can see the views of this course and duration of this course. So we can move what all things are there. Here you can see a course title. So you can give a course title and some tags that can be whether this course is basic or intermediate. And just to see, you can add some tags here. Then content. Under content tab, you can add some of contents inside within this course, what all contents are required, and you can also separate it as sections. You can separate those contents as sections, and if you click add content, you can see the content title. You can give the content title, and under document tab you can specify the course under which course this content is, then type which type of content is this, whether document, video, certification or web page. If you click web page, if you click video, you can see a document URL. You can add a URL here. And if it is document, you can attach a file. Then this is attached by Michelle admin, uploaded by Michelle admin. Then website can be viewed. This is the website in which it is restricted. Then allow preview. If you click this, preview can be given for this content. Then how much duration for this content and description. You can give some description for this content. External links can be added. Quiz rewards. You can add some rewards for first attempt. You can give 10, then according to your need you can give some points according to the attempts. Then questions can be added here. You can add some question here. And you can add answers here. And if it is a correct answer, you can tick this checkbox. Then it will be noted as the correct answer. So this is the way you can add questions. Then statistics. What all, who are the members, then public views. These are the views. Then total views and total comments can be seen. Then under description, you can add some description for this course. Options. Okay, under options, you have a lot of options that can be given for the courses, like whether this course type is documentation or training, then who is responsible for this course, and you can see a website. So restrict publishing to the website. This will be restricted in that website. Then access right, that is enroll policy, whether access right is for public or on invitation, then people invited will only can access. Then on payment need to be done for that, for gaining the access right. Then communication, that is if you tick allow rating, then rating can be given for this course. Then you can add forum is a question answer session. You can ask questions and answers, and for questions and answers some points will be gained, whoever asks the questions and whoever give the answers. Then display. Under display you can see visibility of this course is public. Members only means whoever joins the course, they can view. Okay, featured content, the content can be latest published or most voted, most viewed. Okay, I'm just giving it as public and this as members only. I'm saving it. Now under karma rules, you can see rank goes. How karma rules means how much karma points that need to be given. Finish course then 10, adding review it is 6, add comment 3, vote 3. Okay, then under statistics you can see all the documents, presentation, what all things are there within this course, number of things, that is quizzes, there is only one quiz in this course, and the total visitors and rating, average rating can be seen, and watch time of this course. And above you can see the number of contents, male attendees finished, then 3 attendees here, then 2 reviews, 2 forum posts, and from here itself you can go to the website. Okay, these are the reviews, then forum posts, you can post some questions. Okay, I will talk about it later. Then we can view the course. Okay, under courses you can see all the course, and you can search a course what you need. If you open a course, you can see all the contents, and you can see free preview, that is free preview for this content. And from here also you can add content, and you can see a review. You can add a review and can send review, and it will be recorded here. Then you can share. From here there will be a join button if you want to join the course. This is seen because you have already enrolled, you have already joined. Miss Michelle Edwin is already have already joined this course. That is the reason why it is you are enrolled. Okay. Now we can also see points. Current rank is second rank. It's master, that can be seen. And you can also see the total points. This is the karma points acquired. So those are the things you can see here, and these are the latest achievements of the Michelle Admin Mark Demo, and leaderboard can be viewed here. You can also see the progress of each course. Some of them have been completed by Michelle Admin and some of them are in progress, that can be viewed here. So we can go back. The next thing is that under courses also you can see contents, all the contents that we have created in different view, list tree view, list view and Kanban view. Then reviews can be viewed, all the reviews created by people. Then certifications, when you give a certification for a course and when certificates are created, that can be viewed here. And the percentage of success of that certification also can be viewed. Then, okay, you can also set the course tags and course content tags under configuration. Here you can add content tags, also can be added. Then under forum, you can create e-learning forums for some courses where questions and answers can be given. Questions can be asked and some answers will be given. For asking question and giving answers, some points will be given. So when you create a new e-learning forum, you can give a forum name. And forum mode, whether it is questions or it is a discussion session, that can be mentioned. Then, okay, you can add a website to which it need to be restricted, publishing need to be restricted. Then options, under options you can add a order. Okay, it is, I'm just giving last updated. It can be most voted or relevance, based on relevance or answered. So I'm giving it as last updated. Then e-learning course, you can add a description and karma gains, that is what all points will be given based on asking questions and giving answer. For I have just given asking questions to karma gains, then upvoting means upvoting a question. Someone can upvote a question asked by some other people. So if anyone upvoted your question, then 5 karma points will be given. Then for downvoting, if someone downvoted a question, then it will be negative mark, that whatever you like you can give. Then answer upvoted, answer downvoted, accepting an answer. Then if answer is accepted, then 15 points. Then if answer is flat, then you will get negative 100 marks. Okay. Then karma related rights, that is to gain something. For example, if you want to ask a questions or if you want to download someone's answer, for that such things you need some points, minimum points. So for asking questions you need minimum 3, answering question you need minimum 3, like that way you can give some points. Okay, so these are some rules, rights that you can set here. Downvoting, you need at least 50 points. Like that way there are many rights that can be set. Okay, so this is about a forum. Then you can see the forum post. These are all some of the questions post in some forums. If you can see the forum name, some questions or some discussions and their corresponding forum can be viewed here. The number of views of the forum, number of answers, favorite count, okay, then the website which. So these are the post. So if you go to course, just you can see in the website the forum. So these are some of the forums created. Okay, basics of gardening, you can choose. Here you can ask a question, title can be given and some description of the question, and post your question. So for that some points will be added to Michelle admin, and answer also can be given, can post answer. So for that also some points will be given. And here you can see this is a positive vote. Someone can post. This is, you cannot vote for your own post because he tried to vote for his answer itself. That is not possible. For that I need to log out and log in as someone else. Then he can upvote and downvote. Okay. So for this also you need to log in as someone else. Now we can go back. Then that is about forum, and under reporting you can see reporting, that is courses, all the courses and rating average, number of votes, attendees and visits of each course. Then contents, you can see all the contents of course and can be have different measures like likes, first reward, number of documents, number of certifications. Then it can be filtered by published one, archived one and waiting for validation. Then group by some courses, category and type. You can also add some custom group, and you can define time ranges, it can be last 5 years. Then some searches can be added to favorites. It has list view and pivot view for the contents. Then under reporting you have reviews, so all the reviews with parent document, rating number, count can be viewed. This have pivot view and list view. Then all the quizzes, questions, attempts, counts, done count can be viewed. Forums, then certifications, all the certifications I told you before, average score and success ratio. Then registered and number of attempts, survey stage, in which stage you can view that. So that's all about this module e-learning, and thanks for watching.
If you are interested in knowing more about this, or looking for any Odoo implementation or customization in your business, drop your request to info@cybrosys.com.